Hello friends, this is Prem. I am working with Queen Solutions Limited. Today we will discuss about Oracle Flelx Cluster. Oracle PLC has introduced Flelx Cluster, which have two types of nodes, hub nodes and leaf nodes. Whereas each hub nodes can access the shared storage, leaf nodes do not require direct access to shared storage and are connected to the cluster through hub nodes. In other words, we can say hub nodes in Oracle Flelx Cluster are tightly connected and have direct access to shared storage. In an Oracle Flelx Cluster configuration, hub nodes are also provide storage service for one or more leaf nodes. As per this slide, Flelx Cluster uses hub and spoke topology. Basically, Flelx Cluster is a group of hub nodes. It's based on the condition that zero or more leaf nodes may be connected to a Flelx Cluster. Each leaf node is connected to the cluster through the hub nodes, so leaf node is not needed to connect directly to the storage. The number of hub nodes in Oracle Flelx Cluster can be as many as 64. The number of leaf nodes can be many more. So these are the leaf nodes we can see here, and the leaf nodes are connected to the hub nodes, and hub node directly connected to the shared storage. So leaf node connected to the hub node and hub node connected to the shared storage. So let's move to the next slide, Flelx Cluster scalability. The Flelx Cluster hub and spoke topology segment the cluster into many more manageable groups of nodes. So only the hub nodes, so these are the hub nodes, require direct access to the OCI and voting disk. So these hub nodes can directly access on the OCI and voting disk. Fewer interaction are required between nodes. So how to scale the Flelx Cluster? So there's two ways actually. So the two layered hub and spoke topology is the key feature of Flelx Cluster that allow us to scale well beyond the limits. The hub and spoke topology segments the cluster into groups of nodes, and each group contains a manageable number of nodes. So this segment has two effects. The first effect is, by limiting the size of the hub, contention for key clusterware resource like Oracle Cluster Registry, that is called OCR, and voting disks does not increase significantly due to the addition of the leaf nodes. So this is important because contention for the voting disk can lead to node being ejected from a cluster. So the second effect is, in this there is a less interaction are required between nodes in the cluster. So there is a less administrative network traffic, such as heartbeat exchange between the nodes. This is defined in the diagram in the slide. So we can see here, there is a two diagram we have given, first and this is the second. So according to the first diagram, that is called on the left side, the 12 node Flelx cluster contain 12 interaction path, and on the right side, the fully interconnected 12 node cluster contains 66 possible interaction path for 1000 nodes cluster. The difference would be far more noticeable. Let's assume 40 hub nodes with 24 leaf nodes per hub node. A Flelx cluster contains 1740 possible interaction path. In comparison, a 1000 node fully interconnected cluster contains 499,500 interaction path. So as per this, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. These are 12 nodes, and this is also 12 nodes. So leaf node characteristics. So what is leaf node characteristics in this? This is more loosely coupled to a cluster that are hub nodes. That means, as compared to the hub nodes, leaf nodes are loosely coupled to the cluster. So automatically discover the hub nodes at startup. That means leaf node is automatically discover the hub node when clusterware is started. Do not require direct access to shared storage. So leaf nodes does not require direct access to the shared storage. That means leaf node can participate in the cluster without storage related hardware and network connection. Example, fiber channel network connections. Thank you for watching my video.